Ladies and gentlemen, welcome on my channel Studio Bonn. My name is Michael. Today I want to talk about the most time-consuming project I've ever had. In February 2016, I decided to create a tripod. Not wooden-made or plastic-made, and of course not for a smartphone. It should be a high-performance aluminium tripod in an upper price region. Now we have February 2017. 2016 is gone, thanks God, the baddest and saddest year I've ever had. Now, the whole project is completed. First, let me show you how to rig up the tripod, and after that, I'll be back. Well, as you can see, it is no rocket science to rig up the tripod. Here you can see the aluminium middle spreader, and by the way, I hate floor spreaders. Some scratches here and there. Okay, it's a DIY project. The three screws hold the middle spreader in position and let adjust the angle of the three legs to the deepest position. And by the way, in single mode, it helps to find a better stand on bad ground. I was a little nervous, I don't know why. Normally it's faster to pull out the legs. And please don't forget to calibrate the head with a bubble lever, and yeah, that's all. To collapse the tripod, it's the same way reversed. And it's up to you to imitate some elevator music. Here are the double rubber feet by Gitzel. If you screw them in, you can change between the rubber feet or spikes. And please don't use them on historical wooden floor. Here are some more details. And a very special detail, I couldn't resist implementing it. I have used 6 Swarovski elements for my very special design. Yeah, Swarovski. Anyway, let's talk about more details. First, the weight. My target was under 12 kilograms, and I got it. 11.4 kilograms. Okay, it's very heavy, but it is not designed to make a trekking tour by bicycle across the Himalaya or something like that. It is made for studio work or bigger setups with Arri Elixir or Red Dragon or Blackmagic Ursa 4.6 and heavy big lenses, and it doesn't affect this tripod. It is stable. I've tested the payload with my own weight. I was climbing on it, and my weight, 63-64 kilograms, doesn't affect the brakes. It is absolutely sturdy in that way as I wanted. And torsion dynamic? Not relevant. Not on this tripod. A big point for me. Measurements. The deepest position for the lens will be 88 centimeter by spreading all the three legs. The normal deepest position will 1.06 meters. For normally day work, with me behind the camera, will be a height of 154-155. The highest position will be 163 for the lens. It is very special designed for me. So if taller people want to use it, they got a problem. But it's not my problem. You have seen some screws on the tripod. Please don't count them. More than 150 screws are used. How many holes must I drill? 150 only? Don't forget the big holes in these blocks for the pipes. 200? 300? More? Yes. Nearly 700 holes must be drilled. Let me explain. To drill these 30 and 32 millimeter holes, I have used a special drill bit. The problem was how much space is given for the metallic chips. So, the first step that I have to do was to mark on the blocks the diameter of the drill bit. After that, I have used between 12 and 16 more drillings inside of this circle, just for the chips. And I have used more than 2.5 months just for the big holes. For the finish inside of the holes, I have used a special machine, a special tool. It is called a router. Thanks God, my colleague Ansgar Hallermann has such a router in his cellar at his home. I could use this router at last for 1 year, and so I have to thank Mr. Hallermann very, very much. Danke, Ansgar. You have seen the health ball adapter. It is not made by me, it is bought by Sachtler, because I know my DIY limits. I got it for 141 euros including tax, and even the T-grip screws. I got them under 2 euro each, and the rubber feet by Gitzo, found on eBay too, I have paid 30 euro for 6 pieces. I couldn't say no to this, and it saves me a lot of work and time. Now I will show you some pictures in which you can see a little bit more details and the workflow maybe and the tools that I've used. Before and after, handmade with just a file and my sense of proportion. Some little pieces out of the block for the half ball adapter. The middle connection point for the middle spreader, upside and down, and some additional elements for the connection between the legs. This drilling machine was made in 1992, but the disc saw is brand new for just 104 euro. A little helping tool to get nearly the same angle at the edges of all blocks. And of course some lathing work here and then. Well, that's all. I'm proud of it? Nope. I'm super proud of it. Wow, now I own a tripod in that level I ever wanted. And in a level I couldn't pay for unless I will invest nearly 20% of my annual income. It is absolutely stable and durable, I think, for the rest of my life. And best of all, I can repair it. Finally, some very personal words to my wife. I have to thank her giving me the space and time I could invest in this project. All the evening hours and the weekends I wasn't at home. Darling, thank you for that so much. I'm still in love with you. But that's all for now. Thank you for being here. I hope I could inspire you just a little bit for your own work or for your own projects. Please leave some comments if you want, and if you want to subscribe, it would be a pleasure for me. Have a nice day. Goodbye. See you soon.